Hi, I'm Wyatt from Velocity Merchant Services, or VMS for short, and today I'll be showing you how to run a virtual terminal transaction from anywhere with an internet connection as part of your Clover package. Before we get into the video, I do want to ask that you leave a like and you hit the subscribe button with the bell notification icon turned on. That way it helps you stay informed for whenever we post a new video such as this, and it helps you get the most out of your Clover system. So with all of that out of the way, let's jump into the tutorial. The first thing we're going to do is navigate over to clover.com where we can sign in to our dashboard. And once we're signed in, we'll be able to choose Virtual Terminal at the top left corner and select if we're either taking a payment or sending an invoice. I'll be showing us how to take a payment first. You can choose the transaction type, so either an authorization, a sale, or a verification, and it will ask you the dollar amount for this transaction. There is an option to select if you are doing this transaction over the phone or by mail, so we are going to be selecting that, as well as the tip amount you want to ask the customer to pay, the convenience fee if it applies, as well as a sales tax amount, and a note so you can make sure you know the context of this transaction. You can then search for a customer or business name if it's saved in the system, but I'll be showing us how to do this from scratch. So the first thing it'll ask us for is to type in the card number, the expiration date, and it'll also ask us for the security code and the zip code on the account. And you can save this card on file, but of course it does give you a suggestion to ask the customer before you do this. The last piece of information you'll need is to type in the customer's info, so the first, last name, email, phone number, and the card's billing address. And when all of that is populated, you can then choose to charge them that amount right away. For sending an invoice, we'll choose that option. It'll ask us the dollar amount. We're going to keep it a dollar for this case. And it will ask you to provide a note if it applies. And then it will ask you for the customer's information. In this case, I am going to type in my own info so you can see what the transaction looks like for the customer on their side. Great, and we'll be able to select send invoice from here. And let's go over to my email to see what that looks like. It will give us a confirmation. Alrighty, so I do have the email right here. And it will show us things such as the business name, the dollar amount being charged, and then there is a big button to pay for the transaction. Of course, it'll give us a little more information who we're billing it to. It will lay out every item if it applies. So we're going to choose to pay for this. And it provides the customer a place to type in their card number, the expiration date, the security code, as well as their zip code. And that's how you run a virtual terminal transaction as part of your Clover system for free from anywhere with an internet connection on a capable device. I do want to thank you for watching the video, and again, please make sure you are subscribed with the notifications turned on, so that way whenever we post a new tutorial, you'll be informed on how to use your Clover system to its fullest potential. Thank you very much, and we hope to see you in the next video.